may be seated in his presence. Our God is good. And all the time?
God is always.
Hallelujah. So without wasting for that time, because by the special grace of God, we will be having our communion service also today. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I'd like to prepare to die with Jesus to receive the body and the blood of Jesus that was shed for your sake and my sake. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This morning, by the special grace of God, I want to talk to us on what I titled Covenant Steps to Fulfill Your Divine Purpose. Please, your precious hands together. Covenant steps to fulfill a purpose. Hallelujah. We are going to rise up as usual. Then open with me, please, to the book of Genesis chapter 37. We are going to be having our first reading this morning from Genesis chapter 37, from verse 3 to 10. Hallelujah. It's a passage of about 6 verses. And that is where we are going to be this morning. Blessed be God forever. I'd like us to honor Jesus by standing up in his presence to read the first psalm of this morning. Hallelujah. Are we there in Genesis chapter 37? Verses 3 to 10. Now we are going to read together. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 1, 2, go. Now Israel loved Joseph more than all his children, because he was the son of his own age, and played in the court of many colors. Hallelujah. And when his brethren saw that their father loved him more than all of his brethren, they hated him and could not speak peaceably to him. Hallelujah. And Joseph dreamed a dream, and he told this to his brethren, and they hated him yet more. And he said unto them, "Hear, I pray you, this dream which I have dreamed. For behold, we were burning sheaves in the field, and lo, my sheaf arose and also stood upright. And behold, your sheep stood round about and made obeisance to my sheep." Hallelujah. And his brethren said to him, "Shall thou indeed reign over us? Or shall thou indeed have dominion over us?" And they hated him yet more for his lips and for his words. And he dreamed yet another dream, and told his brethren, and said, "Behold, I have dreamed a dream more. And behold, the sun and the moon and the 11 stars made obeisance to me." And he told this to his father and to his brethren. And his father rebuked him and said unto him, "What is this dream that thou hast dreamed? Shall I and thy mother and thy brethren indeed come to bow down ourselves to thee to the earth?" Hallelujah. Okay, let's conclude it in verse 11. Hallelujah. Verse 11, please.
And
his brethren envied him, for his father observed his saying. So Vashon said, and his father kept his saying in his heart. So sit down in the presence of his majesty. Hallelujah. So I'd like you to listen, and please listen there. Because for the limited time we have, I would like to take you onto the room that leads to purpose. Hallelujah. Every meaningful purpose begins with a dream. Hallelujah. Dreams are one of the medium by which God revealed the future. Every meaningful pursuit begins with a dream. The reason God sometimes speaks to us in dreams is because when we are so much busy and occupied according to our so-called activities. God speaks to us through dreams. Why dreams? Because dreams is a medium by which your future is revealed. For the future you cannot see, you cannot become. Dreams are medium by which God reveals the future. The future you see is the one you can accomplish. The future you picture is the one you actualize. Where there is no picture, the image cannot be formed. Dreams are means by which God speaks when we fall asleep. We saw Joseph here in the very beginning of his journey here to earth. Dreams is the beginning of puzzles, and every meaningful puzzle begins with a dream. God does not reveal dreams to entertain us, but gives us dreams to show us what to become. Every meaningful dream takes us into the beginning of the journey of life. The journey is a race, not a marathon. Sister Ida, you know what is a marathon? Marathon race. Life is a journey and a race, but not a marathon. Marathon reward, the first person to cross the finishing line. Praise Master Jesus. The journey of life has no provision for competition. The journey of life has no room to struggle with children. The journey of life rewards not first to get them, but how well you get them. I see you getting to a place called here this morning.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please, I'd like you to listen carefully. A race is a competition. That does not make the journey of life a competition. Competition reward the fastest in every marathon. But the race of life reward how well and better you get there. In the race of life, there are no competitions. Now, in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1 and 2. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1 and 2. The Bible says, therefore, let us lay aside every sin and evil that weighs us down. Wherefore, he saying you also compass about his great and cloud of witness. Okay, let's take it in my own new international version. He said, therefore, since you are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, he said, therefore, let us run with patience, salvation, say, perseverance, the race marked out, the race that is set before us. He says, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us therefore run the race that is set before us with patience. With patience, the race of life needs to be run with patience. And therefore, let us put aside every competition that is the weight of sin that brings us down, by looking unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. The extended part says, who God elevated because why he humbled himself. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Now, the journey of life must be defined by the purpose. Listen, and listen carefully, please. Let me tell you two vital factors that are important to every purpose. When the purpose of a thing is not known, abuse is unavoidable. Dogs, they like to play with football. But if you give them money and wrap it in form of football, they will only play with it. And you know the most funny part of it? After playing with it and you say to the dog, come on, let's go, let's go. The dog will abandon the money and go with it. Why? Because the value of that money is not known to the dog. When the purpose of a thing is not known, abuse is inevitable. Purpose is the actual reason for God creating us. The journey of life is not as a result of your ability, because you are able. There are people that recruit men for military of any nation requires able-bodied men. But the race of life requires you making yourself available. Praise Master Jesus. Amen. So the race of life begins with your ability to make yourself available. Not because you are able. Because the God you are serving is the God that rewards not your ability, but because you simply make yourself available. Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 11. The Bible says, therefore I turned and saw something under the sun. And the race is not to the swift, as the fastest, nor the battle to the strong, nor riches to men of understanding, nor favor to the men of high skill. He said, but time and chance happens to them all. Praise Master Jesus. Then I returned and saw under the sun that the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong, neither the bread to the wise, nor yet riches to men of understanding, nor yet favor to men of skill, but time and chance happens to them all. It is not a matter of your strength. It is an issue of him that strengthens you. So in every race of life, you need the strength of God to be able to move and arrive in a place called death. The beginning of Joseph's life can be described as a life of hopelessness. The beginning of Joseph's life can be described as a life of helplessness. The beginning of Joseph's life can be described as a life of a foolish dreamer. A foolish dreamer. Where did Joseph end up after the dream? In the pit. Praise Master Jesus. Joseph ended up in the pit, but Mark something there. But that was not the end of the journey. It was simply the beginning of the journey. So it doesn't matter how it looks like in the beginning. In the beginning, it was not pleasant for Joseph. The Bible said that when he dreamt this dream, related dreams that in two forms, the brothers envied him. In your route to the fulfillment of your purpose, expect envyings. But the Bible said the father kept this word in his heart. Now, why purpose? You need the purpose of God to be able to actualize the reason for your creation. As I was saying before, there are two vital factors that are important to every journey. Number one, the purpose of the journey. And number two, the destination of the journey. Life without a purpose is like a man on a mission without a vision. Praise Master Jesus. Life without a purpose is like a motion without a direction. Where there is no direction, confusion is bound to be in place. When a man is on a journey without a destination, he can definitely arrive anywhere. There is never a man that is on a journey without a destination that arrived to a place called there. Praise Master Jesus. A man on a journey without a destination, the destination is the end of that journey. It has to be analyzed. When a man is on a journey without a destination, he will definitely arrive anywhere. And a man that arrives anywhere will definitely arrive nowhere. The true interpretation of nowhere is confusion. Praise Master Jesus. And apart from said calamities, that is why we see anxiety of various kinds in the face of our earth today. I don't know how many of us can still remember about Esther. About Esther was a physicist, a professor of physics, let me put it that way, and a professor of philosophy. He was well recognized because he was one of the pioneers that work in the field of engineering and produces many laws we are practicing today. About Einstein is recognized all over the world, beginning from Czech Republic, Germany, to Deutschland, here in Austria, and of course in the United States of America. About Einstein was well known. One day, he was traveling on a tram, heading to somewhere. So the conductor was going out to check for tickets, and he came across a person sitting there on board. The man was so pleased and happy. God bless you, sir. Good morning. Nice to have you on board. He was telling about Esther. So about Esther was now checking around him to give the man the tickets. So the conductor said, sir, I recognize you so much. You don't need to bother yourself. I know you will definitely pay before you enter the train. About Esther simply ignored the man and continued looking for the tickets. Genesis chapter 2, verse 7. The Bible said, and God formed man out of the dust of the earth and breathed into his nostrils, and man became a living spirit. That is the beginning of life. The only person that has not been created is the person that is never having a purpose. Now, in Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2, the Bible says, write down the revelation. He said, make it plain, make it plain. You have to make it plain, your journey. Let it be known, make it plain on the tablets, so that those that hear it will run with it. He said, because the vision is appointed for a time. Though it may delay, the Bible said, wait for it, for it shall surely come to pass. I see it coming to pass. Yes. In the mighty name of Jesus. There are essential factors in the journey of life that we must journey with. In Jeremiah chapter 29, which is well known to everyone of us, verse 11, the Bible says, for I know the thoughts that I have towards you. He said, this is the thought of good and not of evil. So verses put it actually purpose. He said, for I know the purpose that I have towards you. This is God speaking to you this morning. I don't know how it's looking like in the beginning of your project right now. He said, for I know the thoughts that I think towards you, saith the Lord. Talk of peace and not of evil to give you an expected end. Expected end is the destination. Praise Master Jesus. Expected end is the destination of every journey. Somebody was saying this morning, Brother Peter Prisandu was saying this morning, that we serve a God that sees the end from the beginning. God is the master planner. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. There are so many important issues in verse 13 and 14 of that, you know, Jeremiah chapter 29. We are coming there, sure. Praise Master Jesus. Now, God is saying, write down the revelation, which means identify your journey. Make it play on a tablet so that those that hear it will run with it. You need God's purpose to be able to fulfill the reason why you are created. Life is the vital importance to everyone. The most precious gift God has ever given to man is life. In God's creation, there are no waste products. Praise Master Jesus. In God's creation, you see what was written there now, in that Genesis chapter 2 verse 7. Who would have imagined sand in the first place? Ordinarily, we would think that God, you know, if the Bible was not written for us to see and receive, normally we would think that God will indeed create man from the gold, as precious as gold. You see how God created man from the diamond. But that's not it. Praise Master Jesus. God actually created man from the dust of the earth. Today, you can do anything you like with sand, you play with it, you build with it, you use it for any purpose and throw it away. But it's as important to God as man is important in his sight. He said, from the dust of the earth, God formed man. He formed man with a purpose. He breathed into his nostrils, and man became a living spirit. Praise Master Jesus. Now, in that Jeremiah chapter 1, beginning from verse 2, 3, and 4, he said, and the word of the Lord came to me, saying to Jeremiah, that before you were conceived in your mother's womb, he said, I know you. Praise Master Jesus. Before you were conceived in your mother's womb. Are we there in Jeremiah chapter 1? Okay, go down to verse 3. Praise the Lord. Okay, let's take it from verse 4 so that we can be precise there. Then the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, verse 5 now, before I formed thee in thy belly, I knew thee. And before thou comest forth out of the womb, I sanctify thee and ordain thee as a prophet unto the nations. Now, I was saying that in God's creation, there are no waste products. Man is the greatest raw material in the hand of the Creator. Praise Master Jesus. What matters is either our ability or inability to discover the purpose of life with understanding. This is what eventually determines who ends up the journey of life in the gospel or on the throne. Praise Master Jesus. Now, Joseph's life was the beginning of a wretched man. But in Genesis chapter 41, beginning from verse 45, the Bible said, and Joseph himself was about 30 years old when he entered the palace of Pharaoh. But the beginning, he was in the pit. Joseph was sold into slavery, and he sold again into slavery. A shepherd boy, praise Master Jesus, that was sold into slavery, resold again into prison. Then he was delivered out of prison. Eventually ended up as what? the prime minister of a nation. As you begin the pursuit of your destiny this morning, I see you ending up on the throne. In the mighty name of Jesus. And every power that is assigned or designed to bring you into frustration in the pursuit of your purpose, I decree judgment this morning.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
If that is your portion, let your name show it.
Amen.
Oh, Jesus.
Amen.
In God's creation, there are no waste products. Who told you you are wasted? The most precious gift God has ever created is you. And that is why you are created with a purpose. Your ability to design and determine that purpose is what makes you at the end of the day. I see you being great at the end of the day.
Yeah.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Now, that is the step one. Identify the reason for which you are created. The Bible says, for it is appointed unto man once to die, and after that, the judgment. There is no man that dies without living. First and foremost, you live before we die. Which means it is appointed unto man once to live, and then afterwards, the judgment. Life has no duplicates. That is why God has given us just one of it. You cannot afford to start life. You cannot duplicate life. So never duplicate life out of pressure. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh, because they said, let us go. He said, it's not enough for you to begin the journey of life. The journey of life must begin with a purpose. And that purpose is what we see in the end of it. I see you arriving to a place called here. By purpose, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Put your precious hands together for the Jesus. I hope I'm trying, sister. I'm trying to pick it up gradually so you can be able to interpret perfectly. Because the message of this morning is designed for every hearer. I see you partaking of your home.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, have you sometimes wondered? Okay, slowly. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Have you sometimes wondered why man begins to call you great man and there is nothing to show for it? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
When men begin to call you great man and no greatness to show for it, when people begin to tell you how wonderful you are and there are no wonders in your life, that is why it calls to question. Where am I going? What is the purpose to which I am created? Remember, I said that a man without a purpose is like a man on a mission without a vision. The journey of life must be defined by the vision, which is the purpose to which we were created. The journey of life does not offer you or provide for you the blessings and benefits of God. But the journey of life makes you to be able to offer the benefit and blessings to your world. Take it in the other form. The journey of life does not just give you what God can give as blessings and blessings. The journey of life shows you your position, your responsibility, and your purpose in that journey. These are the things that must be identified. The journey of life does not show you the beautiful places of the world, but the journey of life shows you your purpose and position in the world. In the journey of life, where you cannot identify your purpose, then you need to revisit the beginning. Praise Master Jesus. Every meaningful life begins with a purpose. Where there is no purpose, man is bound to end up anyway. That is the first step. Now, step two, praise Master Jesus. Step two, to covenant fulfillment of your divine purpose. Number two, if you like to call it like that, praise the Lord. Learn to begin little. Learn to begin little. You are expected to begin little. You are permitted to begin little. But you are not expected to end little. In the mighty name of Jesus. Now, in Zechariah chapter 4, verse 10, I so much like this place. Praise the Lord. Zechariah chapter 4, verse 10. For who has despised the days of little beginning shall live to rejoice and see the fruits in the hand of the Lord. Praise the Lord. He said, for these servants are the eyes of the Lord that move to and fro, including your position and your responsibility. He said, these are the eyes of the Lord that move to and fro all the earth. Despise not the days of your little beginning. The life of Jesus can be described as a life from the lowly manger in Bethlehem to the highest throne of heaven. Praise Master Jesus. Joseph began as a shepherd and ended up as the prime minister. Praise Master Jesus. The life of Joseph can be described as a life of a prisoner who became a prime minister. Praise Master Jesus. There is nothing wrong in beginning little. Little apples of today are the mighty oaks of tomorrow. Who knows what is an apple? Apple, they are the little seed of oak. They are the fruits that oak trees produces. When you plant apple, it eventually becomes a mighty oak. Oaks can live up to 1,500 years, but it started as a little stone. The mighty oaks that will eventually grow as much as some meters high can equally begin like this little flower that is here today. The problem with every beginner is that we want to count in millions without the ability to manage hundreds. Praise Master Jesus. The parable of the talents is an issue of equal distribution. Praise Master Jesus. Jesus, the Master, gave equal distribution to the servant and traveled on a far journey. He came back with expectation for a reward. He was not partial, but it was an issue of equal distribution. Life, mark this very carefully. Life is in stages, as men are in sizes. Life is a stage by stage affair. Life is little for little for little, then you get higher and higher. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Whoever begins little does not need to regret, because you are permitted to begin little, but you are not expected to finish more. You know the greatest misfortune of any year is to begin great and end up small. The most unfortunate end of any beginner is to begin as a commander and end up as a servant. Praise Master Jesus. Life is designed for advancements. We are created. There are two things you don't have control over. You don't have control over where you were born. That you were born in Africa does not make somebody born elsewhere more superior. That you were born white does not make somebody born black to look at himself very different. Life is in stages. Every man is created with a purpose, and that purpose must be discovered. The beginning of course will begin with discovery of God's purpose. As you begin, then the first step to take is to begin with you. There is no problem in beginning with you. The issue is to end up small. You are expected to end up great in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Blessed be God. Now, let us see in Exodus chapter 22. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let me check it out. Exodus 23. Verse 30 there. The Bible said, little by little, I will drive them out from before you. Little by little, I will drive them out from before you. You know the questions in my true beginning today? Many wants to begin as a leader that is not led. Many wants to begin as a commander that is not commanded. In God's leadership, there are no overnight leader. God simply traced Moses into the burning bush. That was not the beginning of Moses. God has seen in the heart of Moses the spirit to lead and to exercise peace, to maintain peace. That is why Moses was traced into the burning bush. Praise Master Jesus. Now, can you simply tell me how you can handle yourself when those you help to climb up there will get up there and begin to look down on you? Now, can you imagine or tell me how can you handle the situation when expectations becomes condemnation? Can you be able to tell me when supporters becomes accusers? Can you be able to tell me when men begins to call you great man and nothing great to show for me? This is the beginning of it all. It is permitted to start meeting, and you are not expected to end up meeting. In a situation where you find yourself, you know, your supporter becoming an accuser to you, when the best of friends turning to the worst of enemies, know that there is something wrong in what you gain. In life, it's the stages as men are in sizes. You are expected to begin little, but you are not permitted to stay little. I see you getting higher and higher. In the mighty name of Jesus. Why? Because the Bible said the path of a righteous man, listen carefully. It said the path of a righteous man is like a shining light that shineth brighter and brighter unto a perfect day. I see you arriving to your place of destiny.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Bless the big God forever. Amen. Now listen and listen carefully. Let me tell you, just in the beginning, you can never wish to experience as a beginner. Praise Master Jesus. Three beginnings that you will not wish to experience. Now, in Genesis chapter 13, verse 11, Lot hits the road. You know where he ended up? And ended up in Sodom. Praise Master Jesus. Lot hits the road and ended up in Sodom and Gomorrah. One would have expected Lot when Papa Abraham called him. He said, now the time has finally come so that we can part company to avoid confusion. He said, if you go east, I will go west. If you go north, I will go south. Abraham looked, and the Bible said, and the place of the Jordan was well watered, like the garden to the Lord. What was expected of God is to have told Papa Abraham, thank you very much. I really appreciate how you have been taking care of me and my family with over the years. But now, let me pray about this. Lot never prayed about it. The Bible said, Lot chose for himself the whole way of the Jordan and headed towards Sodom. The meaning and interpretation of Sodom is destruction. The Bible said in the subsequent verses, and he said, and now the men of Sodom were highly corrupt in the sight of God, and God declared a reason to wipe off Sodom. You know the rest of the story. That one expected great man had become very great, ended up as little. You know the remaining part of God, how he needed to sleep with his, you know, daughter for them to preserve a generation. May that not be your portion.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In case you are here this morning and this is your witness, I'd like you to put your precious hands together for Jesus. Now we are dealing with three unfortunate beginnings that you will never wish to experience in life. Now, in Luke chapter 11, if you read from verse 11 to about 32, praise the Lord. Are we there now? Praise the Lord. Okay, let me get it. Let me. In Luke chapter 15, I beg your pardon. Praise the Lord. Luke chapter 15, verse 11 to 32. The prodigal son wandered out of God's purpose. He collected his share of inheritance, and the Bible said he headed into a far nation. It's a full passage there from verse 11 to 32, which is the end of the book. The prodigal son wandered out of purpose. And you know what happened? Life actually taught the prodigal son a prodigal lesson. When life teaches a man the prodigal lesson, you will wish never to experience it in the mighty name of Jesus. May that not be your experience in the name of Jesus. Amen. The prodigal son wandered out of the purpose of God, and he received the prodigal lesson. Now, in Jonah chapter 1, this is the third of him now. The number three steps, unfortunate steps any man can take in the wrong direction. In Jonah chapter 1, beginning from verse 2 and 3. Now, the Bible says, and God commanded Jonah. He said, go and deliver my word unto the people of Nineveh. Praise the Lord. And apart from this, already turning around. But you know what happened? Jonah made a new turn and headed towards Tarshish. Instead of Nineveh, Jonah fashioned out his purpose and journey. You know where Jonah eventually ended up? In the belly of a fish. May that not be your portion. In the mighty name of Jesus. So in the journey of life, you are permitted to begin little, but you are not expected to end up little. I see you ending up higher in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, in Judges chapter 6, precisely from verse 16 or 14, go down to 14. Judges chapter 6, verse 14. And the word of the Lord came to him, saying, go in this might of yours and deliver Israel from the hands of the Midianites. Now, God was speaking to Gideon. He said, go in this might of yours and deliver the children of Israel from the hands of the Midianites. Have I not sent thee? It's a question mark. Praise the Lord. Some other version said, have I not commissioned you? Or, I have commissioned you. It is only what God commissions that secures his provision. Any journey in the pursuit of purpose without a commission can never have his provision. The Bible said, go in this might you have, for because I have commissioned you. The question we need to ask in every journey, not because you are receiving the provisions only, check if God is actually commissioned. If God has actually commissioned the journey in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Now, the very last part of it, which is the step three, identify the place called there. For you to be able to identify that place called there, which is the destination of your journey, you must appreciate everything. You must appreciate every little achievement of that journey. Praise Master Jesus. Appreciate every little thing you receive in the process of that journey. Appreciate and celebrate God for every stage by stage achievement. Praise Master Jesus. Now, when you identify a place called there, you can never miss the vision. When you are on this journey with a clear focus of where you are going, you will be able to be celebrating God from stage to stage half of it. in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now, let us open our Bible to see what actually happened between Jacob. Praise the Lord. Between Jacob and, of course, Prophet Samuel. Now, Genesis chapter 32. Identify every remarkable point in your journey and the pursuit of your purpose. It has to be identified. Genesis chapter 32, verse 30. And the Lord looked up and said, no, okay, we are still there in Judges now. Praise the Lord. Please move with me into Genesis chapter 32. Hallelujah. So Jacob called the name of the place Peniel. He said, because I have seen God here in this position, face to face, and my life is preserved. Praise the Lord. And Jacob called the place Peniel. He said, because this is where I encounter God face to face, and my life is preserved. It has to be identified, every place of breakthrough, every point of breakthrough. Because every point of breakthrough is a point of turning point. You turn around dramatically. Things begin to turn your way. It's a question of identifying where it actually happened so as to be able to define the rest of the future. Now, in 1 Samuel, precisely, 1 Samuel chapter 7, verse 12. Let us see that also. Hallelujah. 1 Samuel chapter 7, verse 12. And then Samuel took a stone and set it up between Mizpah and Shen and called the name of it Ebenezer, saying, this is thus far the Lord has helped us. Praise God and Jesus. Identify every remarkable point in your journey to success. Hallelujah. Yeah. There is always a place called here in every destiny. Struggle can take you anywhere. Praise the Lord. And remember, life is not designed for struggle. You don't struggle in our purpose of God. Purpose can take you anywhere. And a man can arrive anywhere, arrive nowhere. It is only grace and favor and mercy that take you to a place called here. And Samuel broke that stone and placed it and said, this is God's fact you have helped. This is how you have defeated the Philistines before our very eyes. Today, I decree upon your destiny. Amen. Every power that is assigned to terminate your purpose here, God, I terminate it by fire. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. I stand by the authority of the power of God this morning to release fresh grace and baptism. Amen. To be able to fulfill your God purpose in the mighty name. Amen. Whatever opposes the purpose of God for your life, I declare terminal.